IG. Only me and you. Only me and you. Hi, my darling. Hey, loves. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna, and if it's your first time stopping by, wait. Hello, boo. Oh, guess what? My natural hair has been in this twist right now. Flat twist, two flat twists for maybe just 3 days. I washed my hair about 4 days ago, and today I was like, we need to put this hair in some form of braids or something. And I don't really have any plans on what we're going to do, but I'm going to figure out a quick hairstyle right now. And I'm going to make sure that we're using a hair extension that I already have in the house. I found this kinky, this Cuban twist, this one, this kinky hair. One whole pack. I'm going to make this hairdo as simple as possible. The weather right now is getting really cold, it's getting dry. I feel like my natural hair just needs to be in some form of protective style, well moisturized, well taken care of. So we're going to try out some twists. Jumbo twist. So without further ado, my darling, let's get started. First things first, so I'm going to spritz some water and dissolve all of that edge control, and then use some leave-in conditioner, moisturize our hair, make sure it is juicy, because like I mentioned, we're currently in this season of dryness, okay? Yo, I feel like I badly need a hair trim. Like, look at that. Like, the ends of my hair right now are not, they're not ending. You want to let me know down below in the comment section if you want a video on that, when I trim, you know, trim this hair. Also, my God, yo, I wanted to show you all this. My hair has been knotting a lot lately. Like, look at this now. See this whole bunch right here. Because if you know the reason and the solution to this problem, comment down below, because I'm not understanding. I don't even know where to start from. Let me sharp put a little bit of conditioner and see if that works. It's been tangling up. Like, I don't know. And the knots are so big. Oh my God.
Yo, that was a stress. A whole stress. Anyways, we're finally done with the detangling process. Going ahead right now to parting this hair. For this jumbo, yo, when I say jumbo, this hairstyle is going to be jumbo. It literally took us 1.5 hours to achieve this entire hairstyle. It's going to be quick, easy, just a perfect protective hairstyle for this cold month, okay? So patting out the back of our natural hair right there, I'm going to go ahead to apply some shine and jam gel. This is a quick trick that I normally use to pat, you know, pat our natural hair. Once you apply the shine and jam, I feel like somehow, some way, my hand and my fingers can feel that the line is straight. And usually I use like my phone to take a picture from the back. Yo, don't beat yourself so much trying to get the most straight parting, because I can tell you for free that there are days my parting never strikes. But anyways, I'm going to go right there to pat the back of our natural hair, and then pat it out that back into two sections. Use some shine and jam gel, hold our natural hair together, and we're using the rubber band. We're using the rubber band method. I felt like the rubber band method is so good if you have a hard time gripping twists. Like myself, yo, I struggle to grip the roots of my twist, especially jumbo twist. I feel like it just doesn't usually turn out the way I've imagined. So this rubber band method just gives us that, you know, that really good hold at the roots. One thing that we're going to make sure that we're doing is, while parting your hair, or while even manipulating your hair at all, please make sure your hair is moisturized, it's hydrated. So as y'all can see, I'm going ahead to like spritz some leave-in conditioner just so it's soft, it's easy to manipulate. I'm parting it and manipulating it. It's not painful, or it's not even uncomfortable. Also, my darling, you actually want this to be a protective style, right? So moisturize your natural hair before you what? You protect it, so that you can actually be well protected and it's flourishing, nourishing, and getting all the juice that it deserves. Amazing. Once we're done patting our natural hair right there, y'all, this is the head looking like Thumbelina. I ended up with 16 parts on this head, and this is the extension we're using for this hairstyle. This is the Cuban twist in color 1. It's a three times pack, so like three bundles of this hair in one pack. Guess what, We didn't even use all three bundies. I literally ended up using 1.5 out of that, and it was enough for this hairstyle. For this twist right now, I'm going to grab this hair extension. I literally parted it right there into two. I wanted it to be short. I wanted this hairstyle to be sharp, sharp. Tim, 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 we're done. We're going to go ahead right now to grab two strands. So for each twist on our natural head, like each of these twists, I used two strands out of this hair. I wanted it to be thickums, like, you know, I wanted the hair to be thick, thick, and I wanted it to look as natural as possible. Grab this hair extension, fluff it out right there first. Fluff, 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 fluff. You want it to look as natural as possible. You want it to blend with our natural hair type 4. You want it to be blending. So anyone that even tries to look at this hair outside, they will think is what? Is our natural hair. So that's the aim of this, okay? Prior to installing this extension onto our natural hair, went ahead right there to apply some Shine and Jam gel. The gel is just like smoothing our natural hair strands and make it easier to twist. So while twisting, your hair will not be frizzy and it's not be poofing left, right, and center like it has no manners. So once you're done fluffing this hair out, we're going to go ahead right now, grabbing this hair extension, place it right on top of your natural hair, like the little patterns that we have right there. Place it right there, okay? Make like a three-stranded braid, just one single step of a three-stranded braid, just give it that security at the roots. All right, secure it, let it be tight, stay strong, give it that security right there at the roots, just one step like so. There you go. Mm-hmm. And then after one step, split your natural hair into two equal halves. So one of the natural hair is going to go to one side of this hair extension and the other one will go to the other side of this hair extension for the twist that we're going to start twisting. Before you start twisting this hair, make sure that you tuck in. So take your natural hair, tuck it inside the hair extension on each side. I know that sounds a bit confusing, but it doesn't need to be, you know, it doesn't need to be too perfect. Just make it effortless, just in a way that your natural hair is well concealed, so it's not coming off like when you're done twisting or when you're twisting the hair. Just also because this hairstyle is jumbo, right? There's a high likelihood that your natural hair could easily peek through if you're not concealing it and gripping it properly or holding it down like you should. There's a very high chance of it peeking through, and we don't really want that. We want this hairstyle to last for as long as at least 2 weeks, because that's how long I intend keeping this one in. Alright, so once you have your natural hair all wrapped into this hair extension, we're going to go ahead right now to start twisting. Swirl each side of this hair extension first on the opposite direction. So swirl it towards the opposite direction, then you twist. You swirl, then you twist. You swirl, then you twist. That is what gives your twist that extra security. I hope that makes sense. However, y'all, another thing I wanted to mention, for this particular hairstyle, I didn't want the twist to look too tight. So we want the twist to look and feel loose and effortless. If you try to, you know, put so much force on the hair extension while twisting, it might look too shrinkled. And for us, I was going for, you know, the jumbo feel. I wanted to feel like I'm in Jamaica. So a bit of a loose twist. Don't be too tight. Don't be too aggressive with your twisting. Just take your time and then just effortlessly twist this all the way to the very end. my darling, that is basically it for this hairstyle. Like I said, it took an hour 30 minutes. This is that hairstyle that I feel like I would do it again, again, and all over again. And we didn't even use the entire hair extension. It's affordable, it's convenient, it is sharp, sharp, perfect for school, for work, for in between life, and just life in. Because when you style this hair, no, just wait. There's more coming. Soak this hair right there in hot water. Important call out. Yo, don't soak this in hot water for too long. It's just a little soaking you need to do for the end. If you actually drip the whole hair in hot water, it has a chance of unraveling. Because remember, we twisted this all the way down to the end. And the security that we have for this hairstyle at the end is the thin ends. That's why it's important for you to pull this hair extension before you start twisting. In that way, you have these thin ends, and it's these thin ends that, like, you see how thin the ends are, that is actually what gives this twist that security. So twist it all the way to the very end and your hair will be secured. Don't worry about anything unraveling. Next thing after soaking this twist in hot water is to go ahead to apply some foaming mousse. Just use the mousse to seal this hair. I also applied some sheen spray, and y'all, a girl went to bed. This is the following day. No. This one is not even caramel glazed donut. This one is chocolate drizzled pancake. And then to finito this look, we're going to go ahead right now and do what? Accessorize this hair. Just a little pew. I didn't want it to be too much, you know. You want the razzle to dazzle, but not overly dazzle. And that was the look that we are going for. This is basically it for this first hairstyle. Everything down, it just felt, yo, I got so many compliments on this hair. So many compliments, because I went out on this day to the African shop to go and buy ingredients for jollof rice. So everyone was just like, wow, Adanna, your hair looks so good. Anyways, for this next hairstyle right now, we're going to go ahead to pack a little bit of our natural hair right there in the middle. Pack it upwards, like as if you're doing half up, half down, but with a little two strands right there on the side. And this is what the second hairstyle looks like. And the third hairstyle that I rocked and I'm still rocking is this half up, half down. If you're like me, that sometimes you just don't want anything in your face, you want your face to be free, to be breathing fresh air, go ahead and half up, half down your hair. It never fails. Anyways, let me know down below in the comment section which of these three hairstyles was your favorite one. And if you'll be trying out this hairstyle, let me know down below in the comment section as well what you also liked the most about this hairdo, because I love it. Thumbs up, my darling. Comments, subscribe if you haven't subscribed, and I will see you all my lots, my loves. I will see you all my darlings in the next video. Have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye.